Blessings, blessings, everyone. Thank you for joining Word 52. Thank you. Come on in. Thank you, Lady Ann and Minister Marina, for joining us on today. Trying to get my little shirt here correct. Kind of having an issue here. And sometimes when you're looking at yourself in the broadcast, it looks one way, but then it's another way. But it's good. It's all good. It's all good. We're here. And so we thank God for you guys being here with us. We pray that you can hear us and that we're coming through clear. And so today we just want to share a word with you. Thank you. Blessings to you, woman of God, Lady Ann. Thank you for joining us. Thank you for joining, Minister Marine. I love you. Blessings to you. You guys are so faithful and I appreciate it. Oh, there, Sister Evelyn. Thank you for joining us. Want to say hello to everyone that I can. Thank you for joining. Please share the broadcast on this afternoon. Blessings. I pray that your week was blessed. Pray that you had a wonderful and tremendous week. It was a busy week, but it was a good week. And so we are thankful for that. Thank you, Sister Evelyn, for checking my sound. Just want to make sure I'm clear. We're going to give a couple more people time to join. Thank you, Wolf Redeemed. Thank you from Facebook. Thank you for joining us on today from YouTube. Thank you for joining us on today. We pray that you had a blessed week. Thank you for joining us on this afternoon. And we are excited about what God is going to speak to our hearts on today. And so God is always faithful to give us something to say that I pray that will be an inspiration and a help to someone. And so we want to go ahead. I'm going to go ahead and get started here. And the reason why, because I want to really take my time. I'll give people maybe 30 more seconds to join. Blessings to my pastor, none other than the right blessing, Reverend, right Reverend, just teasing, Pastor Carla M. Randall of Saturation Ministries Global. Thank you. Thank you for joining. A tremendous woman of God that is sold out and loves the Lord with all of our heart. And I'm telling you, she is a true shepherd. She keeps us on our toes. She keeps us busy. She keeps us accountable. And I'm thankful that God is using her in this time, in this dispensation. So blessings to you, Pastor Carla Randall. Pastor Kay, that's what we call her. Blessings to you, Evangelist Diane. Women of the Firm Foundation, thank you for joining us. She calls me affectionately Rabbi. So that's her nickname for me. And then I have another nickname, Bishop. So it seems like every place I go, I have some type of handle. And so she knows me as Rabbi. So thank you for joining us, Evangelist Diane. I pray that the family is blessed and you've had a tremendous week. So we want to get back right into the broadcast. We're going to talk about something that we talked about earlier in our Equip Noonday edition, but I felt led to reiterate it again. So we want to talk about the attribute of God's mercy. We want to talk about the mercy of God. And so I want to be intentional about what I talk about today. I want to talk to those of us that feel as though God is not hearing us. God has turned a deaf ear. Feels as though we cannot start again. We may feel a little stuck. We may feel that there are things that's happening in our lives that has hindered us and blocked our progress. And even some of us feel that God is not hearing our prayers. But I want to encourage you and let you know that He's hearing our prayers and that God loves us. Lady Erica, thank you for joining us. Thank you for joining us. The Girl I See You movement. She is doing phenomenal things in the kingdom of God. I call her a purpose pusher. Thank you for joining us on this evening. I know that you're busy. You have a busy schedule, but thank you for this peeking in on us on the night. And so we're going to be talking about the mercies of God. So as I said, I want to be intentional. I want to speak to those that feel as though you have become kind of despondent and kind of discouraged. And even some are hopeless, but I want to give you hope tonight and let you know that God's mercies are new every morning. And so we're going to read a couple of scriptures to you, and then we're going to get right into the exhortation. We won't be before you long. There are two scriptures that I want to look at tonight. The first one Very powerful scripture from the book of Lamentations, and it reads from the third chapter, the 22nd through the 24th verses. It says, "The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness." And so God, his mercies never come to an end. It says that they are new every morning. Blessings to you, Lady Kawan, praying for you. That additional scripture is from Ephesians, the second chapter, and the fourth and the fifth verses. It says, but God, being rich in mercy, because of the great love with which he loved us, even when we were dead in our trespasses, made us alive together with Christ. By grace, you have been saved. And so we want to talk about the mercies of God. Blessings to you, God's girl's creation. Thank you for joining us. The Greek word for mercy is eleos. Eleos, and it focuses on the recipients, which would be me and you, or you and I, and our need for mercy from the one that's able to give us that mercy. And we know that that is God. The Hebrew word, though, is resham, which comes from a place of deep love, and it focuses on the love that God has for us to grant us that mercy. Now, there is a difference between mercy and grace. We will see them used interchangeably, but there is a difference. Mercy is different from grace, okay? So we want to give you those two different meanings. A good way to understand the difference in these two is mercy is not getting what we deserve. In other words, it withholds punishment from us. Say if I stole something, and instead of me going to jail, maybe the court has mercy on me and they say, well, we're just going to give you probation. That's what mercy is like. It's withholding the punishment that I should get, withholding the punishment that you should get. But now grace is getting what we don't deserve. It is unmerited favor. It is unmerited favor. None of us deserves the way that God loves us, but it is unmerited favor. So that is the difference between mercy and grace. Mercy withholds punishment that we should get, while grace gives us favor that we don't deserve. And so both of them are great, and we need both of them. But for tonight's teaching, we are going to be talking about God's mercy. We want to look at the character of mercy. The character of mercy is forgiveness. The character of mercy is forbearance. It is favor. It is kindness. It is infinite and it is perpetual. It is immeasurable. So we see in the scripture in Lamentations, it says that God's mercies never come to an end. His mercies are new every morning. They are his mercies are forgiving. His mercies shows us forbearance. It shows us kindness and it shows us favor. We're talking about the word mercy, and we're talking about in particularly the mercies of God. And then we want to look at, it's a scripture that I think that is very key to what we're talking about tonight, and that is from the book of Psalms. And I'm going to look there from the 136th division of Psalms. I'm just going to read just a few scriptures about the 136th division of Psalms. And it talks about the mercies. And this goes and it solidifies what Lamentation says, that his mercies never come to an end. And the writer of Psalms 136 says, "Oh, give thanks unto the Lord he is good." And then it says, "For his mercies endure forever." It goes on to say, "Oh, give thanks to the God of gods, for his mercies endure forever. Oh, give thanks to the Lord of lords, for his mercy endures forever. To him alone does great wonders, for his mercies endures forever. To him who by wisdom made the heavens, for his mercies endures forever. To him who laid out the earth above the waters, for his mercy endures forever. To him who made great lights, for his mercies endures forever. And it goes on and on, and it's actually 26 verses that talks about the mercy of God, that it endures forever. You know, sometimes, Lady Diane, people may not show us a lot of mercy. In fact, their mercy may run out. But I always like to say this, that God's mercy runs in. You may want to put that in the comments, that God's mercy is not like our mercy. God's mercy never runs out. It never comes to an end. It is infinite. It is perpetual. And so we see in Psalms 136 that his mercy endures forever. Mercy runs in. It never runs out. And we are so grateful. Even during Solomon's time, the phrase they would use, his mercy endures forever, when they were in the house of God worshiping, when they were in the temple. And it says that when they would sing about the mercies of God, and the glory cloud would fill the room. And even when Jehoshaphat, in the times of war, when he would go out, before he would go out to war, he would put the praise and the worshipers there, and they will begin to sing about the mercies of God. And every time they would win the battle. And that can be found in Second Chronicles, in the book of Second Chronicles. So we know that his mercies endures forever. And at the core of mercy, Lady Diane, is the love of God. The love of God. God loves us so much that he shows us mercy. So I want to encourage someone tonight that may be on the line, that you have become kind of discouraged, and you have become somewhat despondent, and you feel like giving up, and you feel like throwing in the towel, and you may even feel like God is not really hearing your prayers. But I want you to know tonight that his mercies for you are new every morning, every before you can even wake up, before you can even open your eyes. His mercy is new for you every morning. And I believe this. I believe strongly that God, if it says that God's mercies endure forever and they are perpetual, then God already had it in his plan and in his sovereignty to put in mercy. That mercy was at there. It was right there for us. It's been there for us. And we are stepping into, and we are experiencing his mercy on a day-to-day basis. At the core, mercy, I said, is love. The Bible speaks of God's love for you and for I, even for the sinner. It says that while we were yet sinners, he died for us. That was mercy. And so his mercy has been extended toward us through the man of Jesus Christ and through the finished work of Jesus Christ, his death, his burial, and his resurrection. And so I want to give you an example of mercy and how that God has shown his mercy while we were yet sinners. And even when we mess up, even now, his mercy is extended towards us. You know, they have a saying in the world, throw yourself on the mercy of the court. In other words, when we throw ourselves on someone's mercy, they have the complete power to either decide our punishment, or either to give us a lesser punishment. And so tonight, some of us, we just need to throw ourselves on the mercies of God, because we are find ourselves in trouble. We are despondent. We have become discouraged. God says that his mercy will never end. It never comes to an end. God is not a man that he should lie, neither the Son of Man need to repent. That he said in his word, he's also able to perform it. And rather, we know it or not, every day his mercies have been extended towards us. I want to deviate just a little bit and talk about the mercy seat of God. The mercy seat was a special place because it was a place of God, and where the glory of God would appear. When he would communicate with Israel in that mercy seat when the priest would go into the Holy of Holies. Upon the Ark of the Covenant was the mercy seat. The symbol of his divine presence would appear and light upon and sit upon the mercy seat. There would literally be a light that would sit upon the mercy seat. And we call that light his Shekinah. And you will hear this people teaching about the Shekinah glory that sit upon the mercy seat. The Bible describes how the mercy seat was at the very center of the Holy of Holies. And so when they would go beyond the veil, when they would go into the temple and beyond the veil, there sit the mercy seat upon top of the Ark of the Covenant. And so this is where they would conduct special ceremonies for forgiveness, and they would dedicate different things and themselves to God upon the mercy seat. The Hebrew word for mercy is kaporeth, and that means a sacrifice that reconciles and leads to peacemaking. Again, that word is kaporeth. It means a sacrifice that reconciles and leads to peacemaking. Once a year, the high priest conducted a special ceremony for forgiveness and for dedication. And so today, it is done annually, and it is known as Yom Kippur, the Day of Atonement. And we've all heard that Yom Kippur, the Day of Atonement, when the priest would go into the Holy of Holies, into the mercy seat of God, and ask for forgiveness. And so on top of the Ark of the Covenant, like I said, was a lid, and that lid was called the mercy seat. And the cloud of God's divine presence would sit upon it. I want to encourage you today. I want you to know that we have a mercy seat in the person of Jesus Christ. Now, the Greek word for mercy seat, and you will find this very interesting. It's in Hebrews 9:5. The Greek word and the meaning of the Greek word is propitiation. The word that we say, it is propitiation. And the word, the Greek word is hilasterion, and that is propitiation. And it carries the idea of the removal of sin because it is associated with the shedding of blood. We're talking about propitiation, and we're talking about the mercy seat of God. And Lady Diane, what has happened in the New Testament, Christ himself has become our mercy seat. Somebody needs to put that in the comments, that Christ himself is our propitiation. He is literally our mercy seat. Paul explains it in his letter into the Romans. He says, being justified freely by his grace through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus, whom God set forth as a propitiation by his blood through faith to demonstrate his righteousness. By he has set forth that mercy seat in the very person of Jesus Christ for a demonstration of his righteousness towards us. Jesus Christ is our mercy seat. By means of the crucifixion, God has provided for you and I a mercy seat once and for all, our sins past, present, and future. I want to tell someone on the line, God is not angry with you. God is not holding a grudge against you. The Bible says that his mercies are new every morning. They never cease. They never come to an end. And I want to further encourage you and let you know that Jesus Christ is our mercy seat, Lady Roslyn, Lady Evelyn, and we can sit on the mercy seat. We can sit on the mercy seat and find grace and mercy to help us in the time of need. Jesus Christ literally is our mercy seat. And I want to invite you to sit on that mercy seat on this evening. Whatever the situation is, whatever your circumstance is, God's mercy is perpetual. God's mercies never come to an end. Jesus Christ is the remedy for our every situation that we are confronted with, every situation that we shall be confronted with. Jesus is our mercy seat. And I believe that the Lady Minister Marina, I believe that God looked down through the corridors of time and he knew that we would need a mercy seat. Even when Adam and Eve sinned, God already had a remedy. God already had a plan for him, for Adam and Eve. God has a plan for each of us. And that plan is salvation. And that plan is Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. Now, some of the benefits of God's mercy. Every morning, God is faithful. Before our eyes can awaken, God's mercies are new every morning. They don't fall short. God's mercy is a gift to God. You and I must keep a repentant heart because we want God's mercies to ever be upon our lives. We have justification from guilt and sin because of the mercies of God. He says that he has removed our transgressions from us as far as the east is from the west. He has removed our transgressions. And he says that he has thrown our sins into the sea of forgetfulness. I don't understand, Lady Diane, how Jesus died for our sins, past, present, and future. He had died for our children's sin and our children's children's sins already. He has been, the love of God has already been appropriated. The mercies of God never come to an end. From generation to generation to generation, they will always be there. They are solidified. They are there forever and forever. Even when we are gone, his mercies never will come to an end. They are eternal. They are everlasting. They are perpetual. They are infinite, even as God's love is for us. And so his mercies, we have been adopted and in Jesus, and we identify, we get our identity through Jesus Christ because of his mercies. We have been placed under grace and not the law because of his mercies. We have been given the Holy Spirit because of the mercies of God, and he lives and he resides on the inside of us. We have been promised that he would help us in every affliction, and he will faithfully deliver us out of all our troubles and all our afflictions. We have assurance of standing in God's election. We have confidence that he's coming back for you and I. We have confidence that nothing and no one can separate us from the love of God. And it's all because of his mercy. My friend, my sister, my brothers, I want you to be encouraged tonight to let you know that God's mercy has been extended to toward you today. His mercies will be extended to you tomorrow and in the days and in the years and in the months to come. I want you to take courage. You know, Spurgeon said it like this, a famous theologian. He said, and I'm telling his writings are inexhaustive, but he said mercy. He talks about the mercies of God being new every morning. And he says every morning ends the night, he says, with mercy. Every morning brings a new day of mercy. Every morning brings new provision for the day. Mercy. Every morning brings new forgiveness for everything that we may fall short in, for every sin that we may commit, even on tomorrow. His mercies will be there for us. Every morning brings new strength for every temptation, every trial, every tribulation, everything that we must be confronted with, even on tomorrow. God's mercies, every morning, they're new every morning with us. And so we have a new and we have a fresh start. And we too, brothers and sisters, we too must show mercy. Even as this has been extended toward us, we too must be quick to show mercy. I know that sometimes it's very difficult. It's very difficult when people have mishandled us, when they have betrayed us, when they have lied to us, when they have walked out on us, when they have done the unforgiving, the things that seem unforgivable, God is saying to you and I that we too must show mercy. We too must show mercy to that one that gets on our nerve, that one that vexes us. God says that we must show mercy to that one that sometimes tries our patience. We must show mercy and we must forgive them over and over again. We must forgive them. We must be kind to that one that has offended us in some way. We must show mercy. You know, I think about all the stories in the Bible and how that God showed mercy, beginning with Adam and Eve, when they literally, they disobeyed him, but God was merciful unto them. Yes, they got put out of the garden, but God was yet merciful because he could have killed them right then. He could have destroyed them right then, but he didn't. God showed mercy. Then I think about the woman that was caught in adultery and how everybody wanted to stone her. They were not very merciful to her, but God stooped down. Jesus stooped down and he wrote something in the sand. And Marina, I don't know what it was. He could have written mercy. I don't know. But he said to them, he looked up and he said, "Those that are without sin, cast the first stone." And one by one, her accusers left. Jesus showed her mercy. He said, "Your sins are forgiven. Go and sin no more." He showed mercy to that one that was caught in adultery. Jesus showed mercy to you and I when we were in places of darkness, when we did some things that are too damnable to even mention, when we mishandled someone, when we mistreated someone, when we were caught in adultery, when we fornicated, when we lied, when we stole, when we betrayed somebody, when we lied, when we deceived someone, Jesus Christ showed us mercy. Even the woman that had the issue of blood, she had no business being in the crowd. She was considered unclean, but she was determined, no matter what it costs, to get to Jesus. She was determined to get to him at any cost. And the Bible says she touched the hem of his garment. And because she did, and she did it in faith, mercy and virtue left Jesus's body. And he literally felt virtue leave his body, and she touched simply the tassel of the garment. The hem of his garment was a tassel, and she touched it, and God showed her mercy, and immediately her issue of blood dried up. Jesus showed Peter mercy. He denied Jesus 3 times, but Jesus had mercy on Peter. And I don't know about you, but God, I want God to have mercy on me. And last, Jesus showed mercy on Saul when he persecuted the church, when he had so many people killed and beheaded. Jesus showed mercy on him when he knocked him off of that donkey. And he says, he looked up and he said, "Saul, Saul, why persecutest thou me?" And he looked, Paul, Saul looked up and he said, "Who art thou, Lord?" He knew. And Jesus had mercy on him and changed his name to Paul. And so we thank God for his mercy on today. I want to encourage somebody to let you know that God will have mercy on us. And it's just like, you know, I don't have children, but I can imagine maybe a child doing something. Maybe that child broke your favorite glass vase or something. They broke it, you know, not trying to break it, but instead of fussing with their child and beating them, and maybe you need to show mercy. Oh, it's nothing wrong with showing mercy. Maybe you mishandled your spouse the wrong way. Maybe you talked to them kind of unkindly and kind of rough. Maybe you talked to that son or that daughter in a manner that was not pleasing to God. I'm admonishing you, even as I admonish myself, to show mercy. Be merciful to that coworker that maybe did not do the right thing, that maybe even lied on you, that maybe took your work and they took the credit for it. What you did, have mercy. Show mercy on them. And so we're talking about the mercies of God. And I want to, before I go, before I close, I pray that you were blessed from the exhortation. But I want to read the scripture again, because I believe it bears repeating, from Lamentations 3:22. And I want you to live in this verse. It says, the steadfast love, in other words, the unchanging love, the love that is solidified for you and I, the love that is solid, the love that is unchanging, unwavering. It says that it never ceases. And then it says his mercies, God's mercies, never come to an end. They are new every morning. Great is his faithfulness toward us. God is faithful even when we are faithless, even when we have not been so good, even when we have found ourselves in a dilemma or in a place where we should not be. God's mercy. Listen, there has been times when I know that my life could have been taken. There have been times that I was in places that I should never have been. There have been things that I have done that I am even ashamed to even mention. There have been things that I've said. There have been times that I have cursed people out. That's before Christ. But things that I have done that I am ashamed of. But if it wasn't, Lady Diane, for the mercies of God, where would any of us be? But we thank God for his mercies, for his mercies. We want to encourage you today to live in the mercies of God. Don't beat yourself up. Don't beat yourself down. Know that God is not a God that condemns, he convicts, but his mercies are new every morning. And I am so thankful, Lady Marina, that God has not given us what we deserve, but his mercies are new every morning. Thank you, Lady Pink, for joining. Listen, God's mercies are new every morning. They never come to the end. They are everlasting to everlasting. And we thank God for his mercies. Listen, I want you to be encouraged this week. Live in the mercies of God. Take courage. Gird up the loins of your mind. You can make it, because you have the greater one on the inside of you. That is the Holy Spirit. And then you have God that's on your side. And he said he'll never leave us nor forsake us. That's the confidence. That's the assurance that we have, that his mercies endures forever and ever and ever. Be encouraged. Go with God. This is Minister Sharon Boyd coming to you. Word 52. Thank you, Lady Marina, God's creation, Holy Spirit. Thank you for joining. Lady Evelyn, Evangelist Diane, Lady Leslie, Lady Erica, blessings to you. Blessings. Thank you for joining us on this evening. Please share the broadcast even when we're off. Thank you, Lady Tanya, for joining us. Blessings to you, Pink Motivation. Blessings to you. Thank you for joining us. Everyone that's here, thank you for joining us. Brother Ken Foster, thank you. Blessings to you, sir. Blessings, Lady Rosalind, Lady Ann. Blessings to you. Thank you for joining. I want you to be encouraged. Go with God. Just want to let you know one more time that God's mercies endures forever for you and I. I love you. Till next week. Go with God. Blessings to you.